Good evening, good evening. Hi, everyone. Today, God is good and God is good all the time. My name is Erin Jarrett, Spiritual Divine. I'm here to give you a little short news on from yesterday news. I'm having difficulty with my equipment, you know, so excuse me. I'm doing double work. You're seeing double today because it was from yesterday and material for today, too, you know, so everything is out of whack right now, you know, but hopefully everything will be back on track, you know, so, First, I just have a little short news for you today. Crime do matter. And yes, crime is a problem. And it do matter. You know, so we may not be able to stop crime completely. We ain't gonna be able to stop completely. But we can try to slow the process. You know, because there are solutions. And there are procedures that we can start doing to try to slow this progress of these guns and rifles, you know, because it's a lot of young people are purchasing these guns and rifles. A lot of young people is doing so much, like the guy at the school, you know, he was under 20 years old, had a rifle, you know, and then he shot his grandma before he went to the school, you know, so that's why down the line, I have down here, we're going to start doing a background check. You know, we have to start toughening up these rules, and we have to start pulling these guns and stuff off the street. You know, we have to toughen it up. You know, so toughening up these rules, we also have to toughen up a person's guns and rifles. We have to make it so tough where they won't be able to just run into a pawn shop and run into a store, buying themselves stuff and going out in the street. You know, so second, I have the age of 25 years old. Just like the guy was 21 years old, I have a rifle. I think that's too young. And I understand y'all procedures are 21 years old. But I think 21 are too young for anyone to have a gun or rifles. You know, that's why a lot of them not in a state of mind are using these weapons because they under 25 years old and they are still young. You know, and they have a lot of crime with older people also. You know, but we need to just start the age at 25 to purchase a gun or rifle. You know, three, we have to make sure they have legal papers. And I put all these rules and procedures months ago. You know, we have to make sure they have legal permit papers. You know, they have to also have driving license to even purchase a gun because the name on the driving license have to match up. They have to have the same name on their papers. You know, so if the police stop them and nothing match up and they under 25 years old with a gun or a rifle, they have the right to start pulling these guns off the street. You know, so we're going to start doing a background check. You know, a background check. You know, all these procedures have to be done when they're trying to purchase a gun. You know, so five, pulling guns off the street. When the police stop you and everything, you know, you don't have the permit, you don't have your driving license, but both names are different, you know, so the police will have the right to pull these, start taking these guns off the street, you know. Six, no one should be wearing a gun on their side. You know, no one should be wearing a gun, walking around with guns on their side. And I understand y'all made it legal, you know, but I, you know, no one should be wearing no gun on their side. Nobody but the police and the military. They're in a security guard. You know, going to work or leaving from work. You know, but no one else should be wearing a gun on their side but the police and the military in a security guard going to work and leaving from work. You know, because if a fight break out, you know, the first thing they're gonna do is grab their side. You know, so then that's a killing right there. That's a crime right there. You know, so we're trying to eliminate all this crime, all this shooting. We're trying to eliminate it. You know, that's firsthand, you know, of shooting somebody. You know, somebody step on your foot or you get into an argument, the first thing you're going to do is grab your side. You know, so we need to start eliminate a lot of, you know, eliminate a lot of these rules. Y'all made this rule legal. You know, I don't want this to be legal. You know, we don't need no one walking around because you can step on their side while they got a gun on their side. And you gone. So that's what we're trying to eliminate a lot of these crimes. So that's the first thing we should start doing is not making it legal for them to walk around with a gun on their side. You know, So it's not a good idea for anyone to wear a gun on their side, but the police and the military and us, our own security guard. You know, so 7, the more guns we pull off the street and more, less people are purchasing guns, you know, there will be less crime, you know. So we start toughening up these rules and have less people purchasing these guns because they have to be 25 on up, you know. And if the police stop them and start pulling off more guns off the street, there will be less crime, you know. We can't stop the crime. We cannot stop it completely. All we're trying to do is slow the process. You know, we're trying to slow the process. You know, something just has to be done with all this crime. Because, you know, what happened with them kids, my heart still go out to that. You know, and then just shooting inside the church. You had 30 some people got killed in the church. You know, this elder lady, 80 years old, went to see her granddaughter graduate and lost her life. You know, so now I did put some procedures out for the graduations also. You know, we have to start following these procedures so everyone can start being safe. You know, because after a while, they're going to start canceling graduation. Mail your diploma in the mail. You know, that lady, 80 years old, went to see her granddaughter graduate and lost her life in the process. You know, so we need to start eliminating these guns. Start going to graduation with a clear bag. You know, and start being searched. I had put that out months ago too. So men have their little wallet or whatever. They don't carry none. But ladies, you know, start going to these graduations with a clear bag. Because starting, you know, you need to start checking these bags before they enter a graduation. You know, because I feel that this lady lost her life just trying to watch her granddaughter graduate. You know, So these are solutions and procedures I came up with, you know, because they were saying that crime, you know, do crime matter? Yes, it matters. Is crime a problem? Yeah, it's a problem. You know, it's a problem and it does matter. You know, there are solutions. There are solutions, you know. We have to just start pulling them off the street, and we have to have less of people purchasing these guns if you start toughening up these rules. You know, we don't want to make it easy for them to just keep constantly running in the store and just grabbing their own out. You know, no. Sometimes you may not be able to purchase a gun the same day because they have to start having a background check. You know, all that going to be on your permit. Papers that all these procedures have to go in place in order for you to walk out of that store with a gun, you know. And we have to toughen up these rules so it won't be so easy for people just running the store, grabbing a gun, and run back out. You know, it has to be procedures that we have to start filing to have less people purchasing guns and start pulling guns off the street to have less guns on the street, you know. And so we may not be able to crack down on all this killing, but we can try to slow the process, you know. So that was my news from yesterday of the difficulty of my equipment, you know. So I see y'all on the next video. Have a nice day.